watch him struggle. He even got up and started walking around the house, and Daddy too said he tried to show out in front of the kid. He know real well he been doing all this walking. That's the kind of man he was. And it reminds me of Beloved by Toni Morrison, when Paul D asked Seth about the death of baby Suze. The question was it hard? I hope she didn't die hard. And Seth responds, shaking her head by saying, soft as cream. Being alive was the hard part. Thursday, March 6th, Daddy Two slipped out. He slipped away, but I want to announce today, he didn't die hard. Rather, being alive was the hard part. Trying to live a life pleasing to God while raising four children and taking care of 10 grandchildren, that was hard. Pastoring a church for 51 years, and as Terrell said, even when those on the inside said it couldn't be done, that was hard. Living a life even to those who were strangers, taking your people in who you didn't even know. And we were talking the other day, thank God they never had a dangerous point in their life. With all the people they brought into the house, God took care of them. Being alive is the hard part, especially when you choose to live well, but Daddy Toot fought on. And I stand to say, thank you, Daddy, for living courageously. You were not crushed by the weight of racism and prejudice. And Terrell mentioned that integration of Asheville schools. I later found out that I'm a little celebrity. Because when the ministers brought the suit against the school system, they listed 7 students who were the plaintiffs, and I was at the top of the list. I ain't know nothing about it, but I thank God for it. Daddy too, you live courageously. You weren't deterred by the naysayers and the doubters. You weren't discouraged by that crowd which would shout praises on Sunday and crucify you on Thursday. You didn't even flinch when we would even try to tell you, stop thinking about that, don't worry about it. No, you fought on in the confidence of who you were and whose you were, and you reminded us to fight on. Be interdirected, not outdirected. Don't let the world squeeze you in. Don't follow the crowd. You need the crowd. Education is the key. Education. Everybody dad too big. First thing he want to know is where you go to church. Then the second question is, are you in school? When the grandkids say, I believe dad too just like school. He meet the waitress and say, how you doing? Where you go to church? Have you thought about going to school? He believed and he felt that as long as you were empowering your mind, nobody and nothing could take anything from you that you would put into you. And his firm conviction, preachers, I gotta talk to us today. His firm conviction was that a call to preach was a call to preparation. And anyone wishing to lead, especially a congregation, must first learn how to serve. For if you don't know how to serve, you can't know how to lead. Sometimes we even said he was merciful. He was persistent. No.